Hello everyone, we are back again with our next video, and in this video we will discuss about the packet handling sequence inside PAN-OS device. So as you can see my screen, this is the complete packet flow of your Palo Alto firewall from packet received stage to your transmit packet stage. So to explain this complete packet flow, I have taken one simple example where I have one R1 router and R2 router. So R1 router is basically behind my Palo Alto Trust Zone and R2 router is basically behind my DMZ zone. So let's assume R1 is trying to connect R2 router on port number 22. So the packet from R1 would look like this, where I have my source part, that is 10.1.1.1, which is my R1 IP. I have my destination IP, which is basically R2 IP, that is 10.1.2.1. Any random source port, and the destination port would be 22. So this complete packet will be forwarded to my Palo Alto firewall. Now, how Palo Alto firewall will process this packet towards R2 router. So let's discuss all those steps through which Palo Alto firewall, or you can say this particular packet, will be going through inside my Palo Alto firewall. So the packet initiated from R1 router and the packet is basically received by my Palo Alto firewall, and it received that particular packet on my interface ETH1/2. Now it will be forwarded to my ingress process. Now what will happen in ingress? In ingress process, it will extract layer 2, layer 3, layer 4 information, and apart from that it will detect the source zone and the interface. So as per our packet, our source zone would be trust and our source interface would be ETH1/2. So once it will detect the source zone information, it will go to the next stage, which is basically your VPN decrypt. So in VPN decryption, if the traffic is basically come through any IPsec VPN or it is a VPN traffic, then it will perform VPN decryption for the tunneled packet. So after decrypting that particular packet, it will again detect the ingress interface and the zone. After detecting that, it will forward that particular packet to your session lookup. In session lookup, we have two paths, fast path and the slow path. If the packet is a part of existing session, then forwarding of packet will be done on the basis of existing session, and we called it as a fast path. And if it is a new connection, then it will follow the next step or stage of your packet flow, and we will basically call this as a slow path. So here in our scenario, we are treating this particular packet as a new connection, and based on the new connection, it will follow the next step of your packet flow. So the next step of the packet flow is basically the next step is forward lookup. in forward lookup, it will find the address interface and zone information from the route lookup. Now, if we talk about our scenario, so in our scenario, what Palo Alto Firewall do in this particular stage is it will do the route lookup towards this particular destination. It will do the route lookup for this particular destination, which is my 10.2.1.1. So based on this destination IP, it will detect that 10.2.1.1 is basically towards my R2 router, and that is behind my interface ETH1/3, and zone is basically DMZ. So it will determine that my address interface is ETH1/3 and the zone is DMZ. After detecting this, it will go to the next stage, which is basically your net policy lookup, destination net lookup, forwarding lookup, source net lookup. Now, after detecting these information, address interface and the zone determine, it will go to the net policy lookup. Now here, if net is configured, now when I say net is configured, they are basically two net, destination net and the source net. So if there is any destination net is configured, then in that case my destination part will be changed. So here if I show you this destination part, if I have done any destination net, so this destination IP will be changed. Now after destination net, destination will be changed, then again the root lookup, address interface and zone determined will be happened. If there is no destination net, then it will check the source net. If there is no source net also, then it will follow the next step of the packet flow. That is basically my user ID lookup. So in user ID lookup, it will fetch the user information using source IP from the user IP table. If there is any user information, after that it will go to the security policy lookup. In my security, it will be working against the original packet that is basically source IP would be your pre-net, destination IP would be your pre-net, destination zone would be your post-net, if there is any netting. Otherwise it will follow the same path and it will check whether that has been allowed or not based on your L3 and L4 information. And on the basis of that, it will create a session and it will update the session timeout in your layer 4 process. Now I have explained this as a new connection. If it was an existing session, then it would have come directly to this stage, which is my L4 processing stage. If you remember, I have explained fast path and the slow path. So if it was an existing session, then it will directly come to my layer 4 processing stage. It will bypass all these stages based on the existing session information. Now after this, it will go to the next stage, which is basically my SSL proxy decryption stage. So if the packet decryption will happen, otherwise it will follow the next stage, which is basically your app ID process. Now here in app ID process, it will identify the application. Like say for an example, if the traffic is coming for SSH, so it will identify that the traffic which is coming, that should be of SSH only. It will identify the application. After application identification, it will perform the content inspection. After content inspection, if it is a VPN traffic, then it will encrypt that particular traffic and it will process the traffic based on the forwarding information, which initially was detected in the forwarding stage. And after that, it will transmit the packet to the respective destination based on its route lookup. So this was the complete packet flow. Hope you all understand this. I try to explain it in a simple way. Hope this will help you all. Thank you, and please like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.